So now that we understand what a half step and whole step is, we've talked about the chromatic scale, I want to talk about why intervals are so important. The main reason is that intervals are what we call key agnostic, meaning it doesn't matter what key you're in. A major third is a major third. A minor second is a minor second. A lot of times we want a way to talk about music that isn't dependent on the key we're in. Sometimes it's appropriate to move music from one key to another, maybe to benefit a vocalist or the range of a specific instrument. We want to be able to think musically, but have it be agnostic regarding the key. We don't want to have to always be thinking about the constraints of a key. So when we write a piece of music in G major, we're going to talk about that in the context of G major, but if we want to talk about it musically in a framework that's universal, could apply to any key, then we want to shift our discussion into the topic of intervals. So again, a major third, that's a major third. It's two whole steps. It's four half steps. From C, it is to all the way to E. From E, it's all the way to G sharp. In other words, talking about intervals allows us to talk about music in a very consistent way without having to be constrained by specific keys. And that's why we want to get into learning intervals right up front early. You're also going to find out that intervals are a great way to talk about how we build scales, how we build chords, how we add chord extensions, and so on. So they're really essential. I highly suggest that at this point, you spend some time familiarizing yourself, really memorizing all of the intervals there are, and then memorizing what they are within individual scales as you start working with different scales and keys in music.